Sarah Ferguson has opened up about nearly getting caught in the 9/11 attacks, which killed almost 3,000 people in the USA in one of the worst acts of terror the world has ever seen. Today marks 22 years since two hijacked planes were flown into the Twin Towers of the World Trade Center in New York, causing untold devastation and killing thousands of people. Another plane was flown into the Pentagon in Washington, D.C., and another crashed into a field in Pennsylvania after heroic passengers on board the aircraft managed to overpower the terrorists. So many people have told of near misses with being caught up in 9/11, from missing trains that delayed workers to security passes not working on office doors. One of those people to have a near miss was Sarah Ferguson, who had a packed schedule full of meetings in NYC. Meghan Markle losing America as Harry zooms ahead, bombshell new poll shows Fergie, a mother of two daughters to Princess Beatrice and Princess Eugenie, started that terrible day with an interview at NBC Studios. She was then due to attend a meeting with her charity Chances for Children at their offices on the 101st floor of the North Tower of the World Trade Center. But on her way to that meeting, she got caught up in heavy traffic, and that delay ultimately saved her life as she wasn't in the tower when the plane hit at 8:46 a.m. Everyone from Chances for Children survived the attack, but 700 employees from financial firm Cantor Fitzgerald, which rented the charity part use of their office, tragically lost their lives. The Duchess of York has since spoken about her near-death experience, telling Hello magazine, "I take every minute as a blessing, I really do, and I really work hard at it." Meghan Markle petrified ex-husband Trevor Engelson will ban explosive book, report, poll reveals public want for a royals cut from line of succession, poll, inside Queen Elizabeth II's diet and favorite foods that helped her live to 96, latest, because the minute you look too far forward, then you're missing now. The minute you look back, you can't go back. Hindsight is a wonderful thing. Before the shocking events of that day, Fergie had designed a ragdoll mascot called Little Red, named predominantly because of its red hair, as well as orange and white dress. In the office, the original doll was sitting on her desk when the plane crashed into the tower, and when she was watching the horrifying footage of the wreckage on TV, she spotted it among the rubble. Fergie told the BBC in 2014, "When it came on TV, I looked and saw Little Red and the presenter said, 'Oh, look, Teresa Child's doll.' And I immediately called up the presenter and said, 'Please, don't worry. Because I was so worried they would think that a child was lost or buried in the rubble. So I said, 'No, it's not a child's doll, it's Little Red and she is a symbol for Chances for Children.'" The Duchess of York's ex-husband Prince Andrew has also spoken about the horrifying moment he heard of the tragedy as he knew she was scheduled to be in that same building. The royal was flying from the UK to Atlanta at the time. He said during an interview in 2006, "It was difficult to remain calm when I had to sit in the plane unable to communicate with New York, knowing Sarah had an office in the World Trade Center and was in New York at the time. I had some small insight into the anguish many families were suffering that day."